The distinctive memorial that you see in the churchyard behind me marks the final resting place of one of Britain's best-loved spy masters. But where am I and who am I referring to? Find out in just a moment. I'm helping a couple who are moving for the first time in 32 years. We show them something very different. So, the house you live in at home?
Nothing like this.
Yeah, I imagine.
But will they settle on something similar?
It's not a house. It's a home.
Good. Yeah?
Yes?
Yeah.
Today, I'm in Wiltshire, in Sevenhampton. And this obelisk marks a spot where author and former intelligence officer Ian Fleming was buried in 1964. Now, Fleming's most famous creation was, of course, James Bond. But Ian wasn't the only Fleming with connections to the intelligence world. His brother Peter played a key role in setting up a secret resistance force based here in Wiltshire in the Second World War. Later on, I'll be learning more about their mission and training. But first, let's find out what else this stunning county has to offer.
Known as the gateway to the West Country, landlocked Wiltshire is bordered by counties including Dorset to the south and Gloucestershire to the north. With a landscape largely shaped by agriculture, Wiltshire is characterised by its rolling, chalky hills and wooded valleys, and its landmarks are visible reminders of a history dating back thousands of years. It's home to one of the highest concentration of prehistoric monuments in the world, including the largest stone circle at Avebury, dating back around 5,000 years. The county is also famous for its collection of white horses carved out of the chalky hills, including one at Westbury, which is 52 metres wide. Wiltshire also has its fair share of attractive market towns, including Marlborough, with its wide Georgian high street, and pretty thatch villages such as Alton Barnes, overlooked by the Pusey Downs. With such a wealth of awe-inspiring architecture set in timeless landscape, it's easy to see why so many people want to make this county their new home.
Wiltshire offers great potential for country living while still remaining connected, courtesy of great road and rail links back into London and Bristol, whilst having good access to the ever-popular southwest coastal region. But you will have to pay a premium for that privilege. The average price of a detached house here in Wiltshire comes in at around £382,000, around £70,000 above the national figure. However, hop over the border into Gloucestershire and you will find pockets offering you substantial savings, which is good news for today's buyers. Who aren't bound by county borders, their priority is proximity to their family.
Bob and Andrea have lived in their current home in Luton, Bedfordshire for the last 32 years. Both now retired from the medical profession, their first encounter was full of drama.
It was just before Christmas and there was an amateur dramatic group associated with the hospital that put on pantomimes for staff and patients. Bob was in the pantomime and I was doing the makeup.
And her first words to me were,
yeah,
you can't go
that.
On stage with makeup like that.
No, with a green neck, I said.
Bob stopped wearing Andrea's makeup and now they've been married for 36 years. Their son and daughter are both in their 30s and have flown the nest, so they feel the time is right to sell the family home in Luton.
We moved here when our son was 1 year old. It was a three-bed semi, and it was big enough for what we needed at the time, but now the children have moved away, so now we're moving to be with family, and that's what we want to do.
Their eldest daughter is moving to Gloucestershire, and Bob and Andrea want to stay close to her, but they're also seeking a quieter pace of life.
It's a lovely part of the country, the Cotswolds nearby, and the housing is really nice down there. We're looking at a more rural,
yep,
environment that we're in now. It's something a little bit more where there's walks nearby. Really, it's a slowdown. We don't want to stop by any means, but it's a chance for us to sort of spread our wings and try different things.
One hobby Bob is keen to develop is photography.
I've been doing it for about 20 years now. It's become a passion, really, I guess. I've looked at all different types of photography, but I've settled on portrait photography, which is something I've been told I have quite a knack for. So photography, yes, burning ambition to get it right and to photograph some wonderful people.
Yeah, but not me.
But not you. No, she doesn't like having a photograph taken.
No.
However, Andrea wants to continue volunteering when she moves to the countryside.
We're both very interested in history and architecture, mm-hmm. I guess. Mm-hmm. And we both volunteer at a national charity not far from here, where that enables us to talk about the history of the building and you photograph all the artifacts. So we would hope to carry that on.
After living in Luton for over 30 years, they know that their life will change, but they're eager to take that next step.
Over the years that we've been here, we've had a wide circle of friends, particularly as the children were growing up. But like us, they have all moved away. And so now we're looking forward to making new friends in our new home environment.
Bob and Andrea would like to be within an hour of their daughter in Cirencester, Gloucestershire. So we'll be looking in the north and west of the county. I'm meeting up with them in Wiltshire to talk property particulars. Good morning, welcome
Good
to
morning.
Wiltshire.
Good morning. Good morning,
nice to see you.
Lovely to see you, and I'm sure it's great to be here. Long way from home.
Definitely. Yep, yes. Very much so.
Let's talk about the house you're after. Because I imagine you're quite used to a certain style of living, having been in your
yes.
current house for how long?
32 years.
Right, OK, so let's just see how adaptable to change you are.
We're just a little settled as we are, so we're open to change.
Are you?
Yes.
I'm not so sure.
I'm not so sure
that we are.
It will depend on the amount of change.
Describe to me the house you think you'd like to live in down here.
So we'd like a reasonable-sized master bedroom.
OK. Or dressing room.
And yeah, then... Probably. Three or four bedrooms, but again, reasonable size. We don't want four bedrooms where actually the third and fourth bedroom is, you know, you can't
touch
really.
The walls.
Well, what do you want four bedrooms for if the children have left home?
Well, if it doesn't have a study, we'd like to have a study.
Yeah,
so
okay.
So we'd turn a bedroom into a study.
Just thinking ahead now, what about things like outbuildings or garages? Could you convert them, or do you have a car? Or?
Yeah, that's my area,
that's
I guess.
That's your dream.
You know, I'm looking for a large garage or outbuilding that has height as well as width, because I want to do portrait photography.
OK.
But it's not a showstopper, because, you know, if there is sufficient land, although we're looking for a manageable garden, if there's sufficient land, I could put a building, perhaps.
I can already see conflicts here. You know, we want a manageable garden, but we want maybe... You mentioned the word land. That always terrifies me.
We don't want huge land. We're not gardeners.
No.
All right. What about style? Because you've got some beautiful stone-built properties
yeah,
in this part of the world.
The stone is lovely, and we love it. As long as the rooms aren't dark, I like reasonably sized windows and good natural light.
You like modern houses by the sounds of it.
Probably, yes.
But the ultra-modern houses seem to have smaller windows.
Yeah,
so
very
that's
small
what
we've
been concerned about when we've been looking.
This is going to be interesting, isn't it?
This is why we haven't moved for 32 years.
Well, it's you know what? I see this a lot. It's prizing people like yourselves out of your house. You've made the decision you want to move.
Yes, definitely.
But you will have to leave a lot of what makes you so comfortable and satisfied with your current home behind you.
Yes, that's true.
And, you know, take it out on me. That's what I'll say, take it out on me. What about price? Remind me of what your budget is.
Maximum of 425.
Maximum 425.
Yes.
All right. Let's see how we get on. I know just the place to start. Come with me.
Lovely.
Thank you.
It's going to be different.
Yep.
That sounds good.
That's what we want.
With a budget of £425,000, Bob and Andrea would like a detached, characterful property with light rooms. They're after four good-sized bedrooms, one of which could be a study. They'd like a manageable garden, and Bob would like a large garage or outbuilding that he can use as a photographic studio. We've chosen three properties that best reflect their wish list, but they won't get to know the price tag until the end of each tour. With our final house, the mystery property, we'll see just how far Bob and Andrea are willing to disrupt the status quo. Our first house is 2 miles from the town of Trowbridge in the village of West Ashton.
Surrounded by peaceful countryside, it's a small yet vibrant village with a community spirit and includes a listed Victorian church, a primary school, and a village hall hosting many social events. Property One is situated on a private lane in the village.
So this is very exciting for you. The first house in 30 years, or first home you could be buying, is it this? What do we think?
Wow.
Not what I expected, but interested to see inside.
Interesting, interesting.
Yeah. This is essentially a converted barn.
Yes.
It is.
Have you ever thought about that?
Yeah, yes. we've looked at them. We have looked at them. So how much are we talking about?
What are you getting?
Yes.
Good question. See that white fencing there?
Yes.
It's beyond that white fencing, around the L shape, to the end there, to the gable end.
Okay.
So you're looking at an L-shaped property.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, what do you think? Typical bloke, right? Typical bloke. Just how much have I got?
Yes. Yes, yeah? Exactly.
Do you like this environment? Do you like the village that we're in?
Yes. Yes. Yeah. It's nice.
Yes. Yeah. Lovely. Yeah. Lovely. Very, very good start.
And of course, Trowbridge has a brewery. I mean, that's got to be a bonus, isn't it?
Yeah. Could be good for the evenings in front of the fire with the beers.
Perfect. Well, if you're up for evenings in front of the fire, have I got a fireplace to show you? Come with me.
Okay.
Good reactions to what is, let's face it, a completely different proposition to their home in Luton. The former barn dates back to the 1800s and it's been renovated and stylishly designed by the current owner.
Now, this is a rather grand way of walking, those lovely doors.
Oh, wow.
Now, look at this for a room.
Oh, amazing. I hadn't expected this from the outside.
Oh, my goodness.
If I'm honest.
That's old and new all in one, isn't it?
So, the house you live in at home?
Nothing like this.
I imagine. Now, the fireplace.
That is some fireplace, isn't it?
It is. See the stonework there?
Yes.
That comes from a nearby railway station.
Oh, right.
It's reclaimed that ironwork along the side there, the wonderful bit of timber going across. The flooring is new, it's oak flooring. But here's another clever design. He decided to lay it so it points you towards the courtyard garden.
Clever.
Oh, okay.
I think you'd live in here, and for the first year, you'd be finding these wonderful quirks.
Yes.
It reflects the guy that's built this place, and you wonder where it's all from. Let me show you the bedrooms through this side now.
Right, okay. Yeah, sure.
At the end of the kitchen, there's a utility room for the white goods as well as a wet room. There are four bedrooms in this former barn, three of those on the ground floor. They include a double, which is adjacent to the family bathroom, and there's a spare room that could be set aside for Bob's photography equipment. Upstairs, on a mezzanine level, there's a guest double. There's no doubt it's an impressive space, but can Bob and Andrea see themselves here with their own belongings and furniture as we explore what could be their master bedroom on the ground floor?
Wow.
Our master bedroom. I think you'll rather like this.
Gosh.
Big enough.
Is it?
I think so. I think so.
We probably could.
We probably could.
I've noticed there's a conversation going on here.
Yes.
Yeah.
I think what's going on here is you're seeing if you can fit them in, but hopefully it's not a deal breaker.
No, it's a nice room.
You've got a bathroom that's almost finished up above.
Okay.
And the owner is going to put a modular staircase in there.
Oh, wow.
Okay.
Oh, it gets better.
I think it's just a question of getting used to it. We've never had a ground floor bedroom.
And as you said before, it's breaking the mould from what we've been used to for 30-odd years and looking at how we could adapt and fit into what is obviously a lovely house.
Yeah.
The reason you'd have to stagger upstairs to bed when you're plastered. So.
Meaning you.
If you knew Andrew.
I like you, Andrew.
That's not the case. That's not the case.
Outside, there's an enclosed courtyard area just off the master bedroom, along with a southwest-facing garden comprising a patio area and manageable lawn, which is accessed via the main living space.
Well, you said a garden as opposed to land, didn't you?
Yes, yes. This is a garden.
Yeah.
That's fine. It can hang the washing out. I can sit out. That's fine.
Yes. OK. That's what a garden is for you, then.
Yeah, that's what a garden is for me,
A sun trap, I think.
Yeah.
It really is, isn't it?
It is, yes.
Already.
Yeah.
But it's like this all the time in Wiltshire. Yeah. Hopefully you've both been thinking about the price.
Oh,
so have a go at guessing it.
You first.
Oh, what a gent.
I think 415,000.
I think it's for £25,000.
OK. This place on the market for £400,000.
Wow.
Oh, wow. That's a surprise.
That makes it twice as hard.
That is a surprise.
Yes.
Pleasant one by the sounds of it.
Yes.
Yeah. It's certainly worth some serious thought.
Absolutely.
Well, give it just that. Go back into this place and have a look around again on your own.
Okay.
And
okay.
I will meet you at the front whenever you're done.
Lovely. Thank you. Thanks very much.
Priced at £400,000, our first house is a converted barn which has been sympathetically restored. There's a light and airy L-shaped living space with feature fireplace and four bedrooms in total, with three on the ground floor. The garden is easy to maintain and they'd be at the heart of a village community.
So this would be the guest bedroom.
This is lovely, isn't it? Yeah,
good
very
size.
Nice, good size.
Nice and light.
Big enough for a double bed, so yeah, spot on.
Very pleasant indeed, and a big surprise, especially from having seen it outside to how big it is inside. It's a TARDIS. This is a lot of house for the money. This has been a fantastic start.
Somebody in this house has got an amazing vision. Whether I could see myself living here, I'm not sure at this moment. It needs some real serious thought. It's very different from where we are. That's not to say it's a deal breaker. I just have to have my head around it as to whether I can live in this way.
I am almost rueing not keeping this as the mystery house, but yeah. We started well with this, haven't we?
That is an amazing start.
I think you'd be hard-pushed to do it better.
Well, we're just going to do it different.
OK.
On to the next one.
All right, okay. Lovely. Wow.
Wiltshire is a mostly rural county covering around 2,000 square miles and features internationally recognised heritage sites, gently undulating terrain and a great abundance of wildlife. In 1962, the Wiltshire Wildlife Trust was formed to protect and conserve the county's countryside heritage. Today it manages a number of wildlife reserves, including this one at Clout's Wood. It also relies on volunteers, and since Bob and Andrea have expressed an interest in getting involved in the community, we sent them to meet Reserve Officer Ellie Jones to find out more about volunteering.
Hi, Ellie. Really nice to meet you.
Yes, you too.
And photo opportunities.
So, as you've noticed, I've got my camera with me. I'm a very keen photographer. What sort of things could I see on the reserve?
Well, we're on an area of chalk downland at the moment, so there's lots of beautiful wildflowers out.
Right.
We see over 12 species of bumblebee.
12?
Yep, and wow. Some great birds as well. Red kites, buzzards, green woodpecker, and spotted flycatcher have been seen recently.
So, oh, wow.
Yeah, quite a bit.
And do you rely on volunteers?
We do. We have an awful lot of volunteers that do brilliant work across our reserves, so it's really important to us.
And what sort of work would they be doing on a day-to-day basis?
It really depends on the reserve and on the time of year, so they could be involved in things like woodland management, coppicing, right. For example, or in the summer you could be doing things like path creation or step construction, so it's really,
wow.
Really variable.
Oh, okay.
Very interesting. Right. Very interesting.
Right, guys, would you like to follow me? We'll go on a wildlife walk.
That'd be fabulous.
Great.
OK.
Surrounded by grazing land, Clout's Wood is a site of special scientific interest and has existed as a wood since the last ice age receded. A haven for insects and wildflowers, it's not long before portrait photographer Bob spots a willing subject.
Never has a bee been photographed so much.
Right, so this is the chalk grassland that we've got here. We've got field and small scabious, which are very characteristic. Yes, this one here. We also have quaking grass, which is one of my favourite grasses because it sort of quakes.
In the wind.
Oh, wow.
This one here is greater knapweed, which is another species characteristic of chalk.
After a short walk, it's camera down and work gloves on.
We're going to be hand pulling this plant here. It's called ragwort, common ragwort. It's a beautiful plant.
It is, isn't it?
A great nectar source and pollen source for invertebrates, butterflies, bees. But unfortunately, it is toxic when ingested for livestock, so we do need to remove it. So what we need to do here is pull this up from the base to make sure that we get the roots.
Like that. Yep.
Ragwort can grow up to 90 centimetres tall and produces yellow, daisy-like flowers during the summer months. Common ragwort produces large numbers of seeds, so you need to be careful when pulling it out not to disperse them. Getting to the base of the roots is tougher than it looks.
So how are you getting on?
Yeah, okay.
I'm not really doing very well here.
Oh dear, well, they'll come back, but it's not a problem, I guess. So always pull them again next time. So
looks like you've got a good pile of it there. Shall we put this all together and put it in the bag?
Yep, indeed.
And I think then we can call it a day.
Okay.
Because there's somebody else I'd like you to meet.
Oh, okay.
Great, thank you.
Lovely,
thanks for your help.
Cloutswood is traditionally managed as a coppice. So to finish off their wildlife walk, Bob and Andrea are meeting horse logger Richard Eames and his horse Elizabeth to find out about this ancient form of woodland management.
So what is it you actually do?
Well, I'm a horse logger, so I basically use Elizabeth to extract the timber that's been felled.
And why does the Wildlife Trust use horses rather than machinery?
On this site, it's very steep. It's quite a small job. So the horse can get into the site, get the timber easily. Also doesn't damage the flora and fauna, particularly the horse. So it's more cost-effective to use a horse here than to bring in machinery.
The art of horse logging is thought to date back some 10,000 years and nearly died out with the onset of machines. But today, traditional forestry skills are making a comeback. And with all this countryside on their doorstep, it's time I got back on my saddle and found Bob and Andrea their perfect house. For our second house, we're staying in the Trowbridge area and heading to the village of North Bradley. Overlooked by one of Wiltshire's famous white horses at Westbury, this village and its larger neighbour, Hawkridge, together feature a range of useful amenities, including a pub, a parish church, and a village hall. Property 2 is right in the heart of North Bradley and couldn't be more different to our first house.
Now, for our second offering, we're going something a bit more conventional, wow. If you like.
Yeah.
You said wow already, so that bodes well.
Yes.
I'm going to be honest with you, we have seen this one online.
Okay.
Yep.
What did you think of it?
We wanted to come and see it.
Oh, what? Yeah.
We saw it, we discounted it. No.
This is brilliant. No.
Yeah. Oh, good.
This is just the one we wanted to see.
Oh, yes. So we're on the right tracks then.
Oh, most definitely.
Excellent.
Built in 1994, this modern detached property has a more conventional layout and in many ways makes the move from their Luton home less of a wrench for Bob and Andrea. We're starting in the first of three living areas.
Let's start with the living room. Not open plan.
No.
You will see.
Love the double aspect. Oh, this is nice.
Nice room. Yeah.
Yes, this is very nice.
Does this replicate more that you're used to living in, your current home?
Yes.
Three
yes.
completely separate yes. living areas.
Yeah. Yeah, this is more us. I think one of the other concerns for me in the other house was being able to get away from each other. So, no,
seriously, in the nicest possible way.
In the yes. nicest possible yes. way, because, yes. for example, we've got a piano. So a piano in that main room is going to really stop anybody else doing anything else.
Well, there's only so
room.
Many times you can listen to chopsticks.
No, exactly. Especially played badly.
Well, totally, let's look at all three then and see how they
Absolutely,
flow. We can
yeah.
actually walk
yeah.
through the dining room if you want to. I'll okay. do that right away.
Yes.
Come
yes,
with
lovely.
Me.
The dining room is just about large enough to entertain close family, but there's another option in the kitchen.
The hallway is just through that door there, but I want you to have that shut so you see the whole utility.
Oh, wow.
And then you can see it goes in. This is, you know, a kitchen breakfast room, really.
Mm-hmm. Yes, mm-hmm. yeah.
Wow. It's yeah. nice to have the extra bit on the far end, kitchen breakfast, or you know, with a dining room, we've got the two options for dining, which is nice, formal or the less formal mm. in the kitchen.
Or the escaping.
Maybe, yes.
So that's the ground floor accommodation covered, although there is a double garage accessed via the utility room that could be an option for Bob's photographic studio. Upstairs there are four good-sized bedrooms, including a large double in the eaves above the garage, a single with lots of storage, and another double which is being used as a study. There's a three-piece family bathroom, and let's not forget the master bedroom.
Well, you get your required amount of bedrooms.
Yes.
Your master faces south.
Oh.
Well, twin aspect, actually, but also yes. ensuite.
Fantastic.
Oh, lovely. Good.
Oh. Good size.
Come on, then. Put your wardrobes in here.
But there's no need. There's a dressing room next door.
Perfect.
Although it's different, there's a lot of the comfortable features that we've got in our existing house. We've got a large bedroom at the moment. This is a large bedroom. Mm. Our bedroom has double aspect. This has got double aspect. Yeah. We've got an ensuite. This has got an ensuite. So it feels comfortable.
Buyers often tell me they'd like to pick up their current house and move it to the country, and it seems we've done that here. Bob and Andrea know what they love and, well, love what they know. And let's be honest, those familiar home comforts are important. Outside, the main garden is to the rear and includes a large patio with pergola.
So, the garden, bigger obviously than the first house.
Mm. Yes.
But still manageable, I was thinking.
Very much so, very much so.
And more our style.
Well, it all is, isn't it?
It is. I can't stop smiling, that's the trouble.
Don't let the owners see you, they'll put the price up.
I know.
What is it then? Can you put it into words why this house is working then?
It's not a house. It's a home.
Good. Yeah?
Yes?
Yeah.
Now, you've had a sneak peek of this on the internet, I know. Can you remember how much this was on the market for?
I would like it to be £420,000, please.
OK.
I would say £418,000.
Well, a week ago, this was on the market for £425,000, but last week it was reduced. It is now on the market for £417,500. So, £500 light. Pretty good guess. But...
Where do we sign?
Really?
Yeah.
As it's gone so well, you really must spend some more time in the house.
Yeah.
And I will meet you whenever you are done. All right?
OK.
That's fabulous.
Thank you. See
you
tomorrow. Thank you. OK.
Oof.
It's gone really well. I often get a bit worried when people have seen a house that's on the internet, but I think this has exceeded expectations. And you heard it from Bob himself. It's not a house. For them, it's a potential new home.
Over £7,000 below their budget, the second property is a modern detached family home with three separate living areas and four good-sized bedrooms. There's a double garage for Bob's photographic equipment, and the house comes with a manageable garden with entertaining space.
Well, this is a good-sized guest bedroom.
Yeah, worked perfectly.
Nice storage.
This is very nice. I can't stop smiling. Boxes ticked all over the place. We've already started to move our furniture in theory. Everything will go into this house. The last house, we would have had to make quite a few modifications or leave stuff behind. Here, we can bring the whole thing.
I'd like to explore the area a little bit more, go into Trowbridge, see what facilities are around, explore the village a little bit more. But initial feelings, yes, I could definitely see us living here.
I was worried you weren't going to come out then.
Oh, do we have to? Moving in.
Yes, please.
So, yes, please, from both of you. This is a contender, isn't it?
Definitely.
Does that mean tomorrow I can choose something really wacky?
That'll be interesting.
We're still very interested to see what's tomorrow.
Well, this is the one to beat. Come with me.
Cheers. Yeah.
Sunny Wiltshire with a £425,000 budget and retirees Bob and Andrea from Luton in Bedfordshire, who haven't moved for three decades. Coming up, the mystery house divides the camp.
It's in style with the house and it's different.
In the nicest possible way, Bob. I don't care what you think.
No, I'm sure.
Because you like it.
Yes.
I'm worried about the doubting Thomas over here.
And down in the woods, there's a big surprise as I discover Wiltshire's wartime secrets.
Open up!
What I must say, Andrew and Bob were absolutely buzzing when they got back to the hotel last night, talking about house number two, especially Bob waxing lyrical about how he was going to convert that double garage into a photography studio. But that doesn't mean an early bath for me. I know they're moving from a fairly modern property, and house two again was a modern house, wasn't it? So I want one more chance to show them something with a bit of history, which is one of the compromises with today's mystery house. The other are slightly smaller proportions inside the house itself. But if they're able to see through these two things, they'll be rewarded with a much shorter commute time to their daughter in Cirencester. Let's see how we go.
Our final offering means we have to cross the border into Gloucestershire and head to the market town of Nailsworth.
Set in a wooded valley, the characterful town prospered thanks to the Cotswolds' wool and cloth trade. And today, many of the old mills and workers' cottages have been converted into restaurants and hotels. The Mystery House, situated on the rural edges of Nailsworth, gives our couple all the benefits of town living on their doorstep. But it's a much older model than our second house yesterday, and I think it's the age factor that's going to be the biggest challenge for our couple.
Well, you'll know you're only half an hour from Cirencester, where your daughter lives.
Mm-hmm. OK.
If you lived in that house.
Oh, wow.
Right.
Oh, right.
Oh. I like
that's not what I was expecting.
Wow. You said wow at every house.
I know,
Bob.
I know. My heart speaks first, and then I'll let the brain come in and sort out the detail.
That's called Andrea.
No, she does the other way round.
So then, Andrea, you like the stone,
I
you
like
just
the
said.
Stone. Mm. If I'm absolutely honest, the state of the roof worries me a little bit.
That is beautiful local stones
stone
on the
yes,
roof.
Yeah.
That's, you know, that's decent.
I've yet to be decided, I think. I'm going to stay inside.
Yes. Let's look inside, come on.
As suspected, it seems it's out with the old and in with the new. But this 19th-century traditional Cotswolds cottage is packed with character, and I'm hopeful I can convince Andrea of its historic merits.
Now, straight in to what I thought was a fairly well-lit kitchen.
Yes. Good size.
It's a good size. It's not my style.
Not your style? OK, all right. It's in style with the house, and it's different.
In the nicest possible way, Bob, I don't care what you think.
No,
I'm
sure you
because
do.
You like it.
Yes.
I'm worried about the doubting Thomas over here. I'm going to push you on this, Andrea.
I would like to see more. It's been done very nicely.
It has, yeah.
But
it's a lovely kitchen.
It's not me.
I think Andrea's body language says it all.
Well, it's semi-open plan. Feel continues. You've got your dining room here, and then, just mind your step there, a snug-like living room.
Yes, very snug.
Look at that face. Look at that face.
Too small.
Yeah, it's too small.
Is it?
Yeah.
Way too small.
We wouldn't get anything in here.
We would literally have to get rid of everything and start again.
Well, that would be refreshing, wouldn't it?
That's
true.
But it's a step too far.
Is it?
I think it might be a step too far.
Well, it was always going to be hard beating house two, as Bob and Andrea and their furniture felt so at home there. Upstairs, there are four bedrooms spread over two floors. On the top floor, there's a double in the eaves and a single bedroom. On the first floor, they'll find the family bathroom, a guest double, as well as the master.
Up on this first floor, you get two double bedrooms and a bathroom, but amazing views.
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
That's a good sized room as well.
It is, isn't it?
I mean, look at that. Like, waking up to that view.
How green is my valley? That's lovely.
Yes, pretty green.
Yeah. This is a good sized room.
It is a good sized room.
Good sized rooms don't buy houses.
No, but it depends what I could put or what we could put in the other rooms.
You put him in one of them.
Might put him in another house.
That's what the garage is for.
Ah, yes.
See? That's a nice big room I've got. Yeah.
I was there when that happened. But I don't think it's the size of the rooms. I think it's that intangible thing, that feeling.
That first 10 seconds, as everybody says, as you walk into a house, if it doesn't grab you within 10 seconds, it's probably not for you.
You're the Iron Lady of house tours. This woman's not for changing her mind. I quite like it. Well, let's go back outside.
Okay.
And now I'm going to make you sweat over the price.
Oh, dear.
Who am I going to make go first? I think Andrea.
Yes.
You deserve it, Andrea.
Yes.
Despite its charm and appeal, the historic credentials of our mystery house aren't resonating with them. Outside, the main garden is to the front and side of the house, with a sloping lawn and patio. But the property also benefits from two garages, the larger of which could make an excellent photo studio.
OK, then how much do we think this mystery house is on the market for?
I'm probably going to say £380,000.
Oh, right, OK.
I'm going to say £420,000.
This place is on the market for... You're way out. £379,950. You're good at this, aren't you?
She is. Wow.
So, although you've retired, maybe you could become an estate agent.
I don't think so. I wouldn't have any clients.
Have a snoop around. I will tell you what, I'll probably be sat right here.
Lovely. Okay.
See you in a moment.
Thank you.
See you in a while. Thank you.
£45,000 under budget, our mystery house has the lowest price tag of all three properties, despite being located in more expensive Gloucestershire. It's a traditional Cotswold stone cottage with a large kitchen diner and four bedrooms. There are outbuilding options for Bob's studio and the garden is easy to maintain.
It's a very nice house. It's been decorated very well. It's a very nice location near a very nice town. And it will be a lovely home for somebody at a good price.
It's a lovely house. It's been very nicely done inside. It has a lot of features. Nice for a family, a small young family growing, but not for a couple of older people such as us, perhaps.
Have you used this time to really get a feel for the place and maybe start chatting things through about location over property?
Yes, I think so.
Yes. We've got a much better idea than when we started the process.
Good. Well, now I'm going to give you a bit more time. I'm going to take you somewhere to have a good chat about all three properties.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then I'll find out what you want to do.
Yeah? Okay.
Come
right.
with me.
Thank you. Thank you.
During the Second World War, the Wiltshire countryside played host to a secret band of brothers. One of those in charge was Captain Peter Fleming, brother of spy writer Ian Fleming. He was tasked by Sir Winston Churchill to train an underground resistance network designed to disrupt enemy lines in the event of a German invasion, a threat that was very real in 1940. The men, all volunteers, were trained here at the Coleshill Estate. I'm meeting Bill Ashby from the Coleshill Auxiliary Research Team to find out what life was like in this secret guerrilla army.
Now, Bill, there's an amazing history, an unknown history attached to the auxiliaries, and part of that is Peter Fleming, Ian Fleming's brother. How involved was he?
Well, he was a key man. Peter Fleming was recruited to train men to go to ground. So if the Germans came, they would hide, and they would then come out and try and delay the enemy by attacking stores and vehicles and anything, everything but actually go to war and fight them.
Right. So we were very much under the threat of invasion ourselves here in the UK. Talk me through the training that these guys had then.
They were trained to use the latest equipment. A plastic explosive was only just coming out then. They would set up charges onto a railway line, for example. And the idea was that the railway would have been bringing in German reinforcements.
Of course.
So blow the line up or blow the tunnel up, and the bridge up.
This would have been just at Mather, so you got the railway girder here.
This is a detonator. The train come on, that would fire that.
Bang.
As well as learning guerrilla warfare tactics, volunteers were trained in intelligence, in particular getting messages from the front to higher command. Auxiliary units would plant secret messages to be picked up later in what were known as dead letterboxes.
Dead letterboxes. Is one near here?
Yep. You're getting colder.
Colder?
Yeah. You're getting warm. Getting hot.
What? How can I be very hot? I've got a chunk of wood in my hand. Well, go on then.
Let me show you.
Get it out. Oh, what an idiot. Brilliant.
A dummy bolt. There's a curled up message inside the bolt.
This is ingenious. And then inside there.
That's it.
Mr. Irwin, you are rubbish at finding messages.
Secrecy was of the utmost importance, so outposts and bunkers were hidden from plain sight, but in the most ordinary of places.
Let me show you. Open up!
The operation base, like this one, would be where the men would live for weeks at a time and plan their acts of sabotage.
And how many people would have been staying in here, then?
Maybe up to eight.
Well, cosy, isn't it?
Yep, we've got bunks, maybe four sleeping and four doing things.
Now, you say four sleeping, four doing things. These activities, I imagine they'd probably be taking place under the cover of darkness.
Yes. There would have been two men out during the day on reconnaissance.
Right.
Choosing the target that would be attacked that night. They'd come back.
Right.
Prepare their explosives, whatever's necessary. Yes. In here.
So rest and prepare by day.
That's it.
Action by night. Although the men's training was never put into practice, many went on to join the SAS, using the skills taught here at this top-secret Special Forces training ground in the heart of the Wiltshire countryside. Well, I think it's fair to say that house number two is the clear favourite. But let's remember, it's been over 30 years since Bob and Andrea bought a house together, so this is a huge decision. I've given them a few hours to think things through, so let's find out what their thoughts are. Well, you could get used to this, couldn't you?
Absolutely.
You wouldn't want to mow it, though, would you?
No.
Not every week. Do you have a favourite house? He asked knowingly. Of course you do.
I think the second house.
Yeah, there was one that had a little advantage over the rest, perhaps.
Yeah. What was it about house number two, then?
I think the size of the rooms, it gave us the different rooms that we wanted. Mm. It gave us the size of garden that we wanted and that we didn't want anything huge.
I haven't been inside your house.
No.
Would you say you were looking, to some extent, for a fair amount of replication?
Probably.
I think so, yes, because your favourite stock phrase, if we could move it down here, we would. And that's why I think that house number two was the closest to what we currently have, in which we're very comfortable.
What's the next step for you guys?
Well, before we go home tomorrow, we're going to go back to the area and explore the location a little bit more. And we have already arranged to see the house again.
Fantastic news.
Yes.
You don't hang around here.
No.
I'm really, really chuffed. Please let us know what you decide.
Of course, we will. Yes, and no thank problem. You very much. It's been a real experience.
Really, really good fun.
I've enjoyed myself as well.
Thank you.
The only thing remaining to do is eat brownies. Let me tell you, I'm much better than that for finding houses. You know, I think the main reason why Bob and Andrea liked house number two so much is because it felt so familiar, and that's what helped them feel so comfortable when they walked around the property. So, fingers crossed, their second viewing tomorrow morning, house number two goes very well. But if not, if there are question marks there, it certainly wouldn't surprise me to hear that they're looking for a property somewhere over the border, perhaps closer to their daughter in Cirencester. Looking forward to finding out. See you next time. If you would like to escape to the country in England, Scotland, Wales or Northern Ireland and need our help, you can apply online at bbc.co.uk/beonashow.